what they say.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing Vita Bella. Hearts will play tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like a gay tarantella. When the stars make you drool, just like pasta for zoo, that's amore. In a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signore. Scusa me, but you see back in old Napoli, that's amore.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
That's amore.
When the world seems
amore.
When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, you're in love.
You walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signore. Scusa me, but you see back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Amore, that's amore.
Here is my hand, and with it, I give you my whole heart.
Go on, don't be shy. Get him your hand, too, and then you'll be engaged. And soon, very soon, you'll be married.
Sweet Silvio, here is my hand. I promise to be your wife.
And I promise to be your husband.
Oh, huzzah! Wonderful! Now that's settled, and there's no going back.
Lucky girl, and with me just burst to get married.
You all are witnesses to the betrothal of my daughter, Clarice, to Signor Silvio, the most worthy son of our good Dr. Lombardo. Oh,
we are, sir! And I thank you for the honor.
Truly, we may say this marriage was made in heaven. For had it not been for the sudden death of Federico Rasponi, my business associate in Turin, to whom I promised my daughter, I could not have then given her to my dear son-in-law.
I can call myself fortunate indeed, sir. I know not if Signora Clarice will say the same.
Oh, you wrong me, dear Silvio. You should know if I love you. I could have married Federigo Rasponi in obedience to my father, but my heart has always been yours.
'Tis true indeed. The will of heaven is wrought in unexpected ways. Now, pray, sir, how did Federigo Rasponi come to die?
He died fighting in a duel to defend his sister's honor, struck down with a single blow, from what I understand.
This happened in Turin.
In Turin.
Poor fellow, I am sorry to hear it.
You knew Federigo Rasponi?
Certainly I knew him. I lived in Turin for 3 years. I also knew his sister, a young woman of such spirit. She used to dress like a man and ride on horseback. Ow, what a pair!
Wait, come. No more talk of unhappy things. Do you know what we need, Signor Brighella? We need a good dinner for all of us at your inn.
Say no more, I'm at your service. I will go into my inn and cook up something fine that will please everyone.
Excellent. Schmeldina, see who's at the door.
Right away. Can we be excused, Father, sir?
To go where?
Oh, I don't know. To my room?
No. Put her down. Put her down. You stay here.
I don't care.
These two mustn't be left alone.
Prudence above all.
My humble greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, what a fine company. Oh, very fine indeed.
Who are you, friend, and what is your business?
Who is this divine lady?
That is my daughter.
I'm delighted to hear it.
And that is her fiancé.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear it. Who are you?
I'm her maid, sir.
Oh, I congratulate her.
Oh, who are you? Who sent you? What is your business?
Whoa, 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 whoa. Three questions at once is too much for a poor man.
Is it him or is it me?
I think it's him.
Are you the one who's getting married?
Oh, sir.
No, sir.
Will you tell me who you are?
No.
How will you go about your business?
I am the servant of my master. We should have a talk sometime about conjugal relations.
Who is your master?
Oh, he is a gentleman from Turin. His name is Federigo Responi. And he would like to come in, and I'm supposed to wait for an answer. Now, does anybody want to know anything else? No? Good. Now, back to you, my dear.
What the hell are you talking about? Talk to me.
Now, you want to know who I am? I am Truffaldine Batocchio from Bergamo.
I don't care who you are. Who is your master? Now, one more time. I didn't quite catch the name.
Poor old man. He must be deaf. My master is Federigo Responi from Turin.
Stop. You are insane. Federigo Responi is dead.
He's dead?
Dead.
Dead. Dead.
Oh, my dear Lord. My poor master is dead. He was alive when I left him downstairs. You really mean dead?
Absolutely, positively dead.
Oh, my poor master. He must have met with some sort of accident. Well, thank you very much.
Can I do nothing more for you?
No, if he's dead, there's nothing more to do. But I better go see for myself.
Well, what do you think? Is he completely crazy or just stupid?
Both.
I kind of like him.
But suddenly Grasponi from Turin.
If it is true that he is here, this would be the worst possible tragedy that could ever happen.
If he is alive and here after all, he has come too late.
I'm amazed! Is this any way to treat a search ranger? Is this how you treat servants? It is unforgivable. I can't believe it. You told me that Federigo Responi was dead.
And
what? He's alive! And outside and waiting to see you.
Signor Federigo!
Signor Federigo!
Responi!
Responi!
Of Turin!
Of Turin!
If you say another word, I'll break your head!
No, Signor Pantalone! I know. Tell him to bring in the person he believes to be Federigo Responi.
Fine! Go! And return with the walking dead.
Well, he lives. And soon you will see him with your own eyes. And you, my dear, you and I will have a talk.
Where's
and soon.
Yes!
Oh, Silvio, I'm trembling all over.
Whatever happens, you will be mine. Now is the hour of truth.
Probably some scoundrel trying to play a trick on me.
Trust me, I know, Senor Federigo. We'll just see if this is he.
Oh, no. The little fellow couldn't really be a scoundrel.
Pardon me, sir.
Signor Pantalone, the gentleman whose grace I so admire in your letters in no way corresponds with the treatment I've received. I send my servant as an ambassador of goodwill, and you leave me standing in the open courtyard for half an hour before you allow me to enter.
Pardon our bad manners, sir, but may we inquire as to who you are?
Federigo Responi of Turin, at your service.
What is this? This isn't Federigo. Oh, this is his sister, Beatrice.
I am absolutely astonished, particularly after we received the news of your terrible death. I don't know what to believe anymore.
I know you heard I was killed in a duel, but thanks to the heavens above, I was only wounded, and as soon as I was restored to health, I embarked on this trip to Venice as you and I had planned.
Well, I don't know what to say, since I've heard with certainty and from people that I trusted you are dead, if you can provide no proof to the contrary.
Here are four letters from your friends, business acquaintances, and one from your bank manager. Read what is enclosed, and you will ascertain that I am, in fact, myself.
Oh, Sylvia, we're lost.
I will lose my life before I lose you.
Oh, no. What is Brighella doing here? Oh, my friend, you look familiar.
Yes, senor. You must remember Brighella of Terran.
Of course. Now I recognize you. What brings you to Venice? Oh, for the love of God, please don't give me away.
Don't worry. I run an inn and I'm at your service, sir.
Oh, it would be a pleasure to stay at your
inn. Oh, you do me an honor, sir.
Well, it is clear to me that these letters accompanied Signor Federigo Rasponi, and since you, sir, present me with them, I am left to believe, well, what they say.
Ah, if you have any remaining doubt, Brighella here can assure you that I am, in fact, myself.
There is none other.
Well, since I've heard it from my trusted friend, Brighella, and read these letters, sir, I am pleased to meet your acquaintance, and I ask that you forgive me my doubts.
Oh,
of course.
Dear father, can it be that this is Federigo Rasponi?
It must be.
Oh, my heart is breaking. What will happen to us?
Have no fear. You are mine, and I will protect that to the death.
Signor Pantalone, who is this young lady?
Oh, that's my daughter Clarice.
Oh, the one whom I am destined to marry?
Yes, sir, just that.
Oh, Signora, allow me the honor of making your acquaintance.
Your devoted servant.
And this young man is a relative of yours?
Oh, yes, he's my nephew.
No, sir, I am not your nephew. I am engaged to Signora Clarice. Oh, bravo, don't go down without a fight.
What's this? You're engaged to Clarice? Was she not promised to me?
Oh, dear Signor Federigo, until your arrival today, we believed that you were dead, whereupon Clarice was promised to Silvio here. But now that you are alive, Clarice is yours, if you still want her. I stand by my word. Signor Silvio, there's nothing more for you to say here.
Surely Federigo would never accept a bride who has given her hand to another.
Oh, no. I'm happy to have her. Plus, I want to have myself a little fun here.
Sir, you have arrived too late. Clarice is going to be mine. I will never give her up. Signor Pantalone has promised her to me. I want Clarice, and you, sir, will find me a worthy opponent in this battle. Oh. Oh.
Signor has arrived too late. Signora Clarice was promised to my son. Now, in this, the law speaks clearly. Prior in tempore, potior in jure.
And you, my future wife-to-be, have you nothing to say?
I say I'd sooner marry the devil.
Oh, come back here, you little brat. And stop making such a scene, I tell you.
Oh, Signor Pantalone, stay. We won't get anywhere with her by being so harsh. Soon, I hope to earn her affection. In the meantime, we can go over our business dealings together.
Oh, well, you'll see that all of our affairs are in order. And when the goods arrive, you'll be paid a proper fee.
Excellent. Yes. If you will permit me, I will go now with Brighella to settle in.
If I can provide you with anything, sir, just let me know.
I would be grateful for an advance of a small amount of money. I didn't bring much with me in case I was robbed on the journey.
Oh, of course, I'll have some sent over right away.
I'll send my servant to pick it up. He's quite honest, can be trusted with anything.
Very well.
I thank you.
And if I can provide you with anything else, please, just call on me. Until then, sir, good day.
A good day.
Now then, senor.
A bad preacher!
Oh, shoo, be quiet! Don't let anyone know who I am! My poor brother is dead! He was killed. killed in a duel by Florindo Aretusi. You remember Florindo? He loved me and my brother would not have it. They fought. Federigo fell. Florindo fled. And I heard he set straight for Venice, so I put on my brother's clothing and followed him with these letters of credit in his name. I know I can collect all of the money from Federigo's accounts, and then I can find... Florindo. Oh, we'll need nothing else. We'll live on love. Oh, Brighella. Help me. I know I can compensate you more than fairly.
That's all fine, but I don't want to be the cause of Signor Pantalone giving you money in good faith and then finding out we fooled him.
Oh, but we're not fooling him, Brighella. My brother is dead, but I am his heir.
Oh, that's true. Then why are you in disguise?
If it were discovered that I am a woman, Signor Pantalone would try to treat me as if he were my guardian. I couldn't travel freely. Then how would I find Florindo? Oh, I must have my liberty, if only for a little while. Oh, Brighella, help me to it.
I got it. You were always one to have your own way. You can depend on me.
Oh, thanks. May we go to your inn now?
Let's go. What love makes people do.
Where am I?
Oh, hey. Excuse me.
Hey, whoa!
Whoa!
No, no! Jesus! Help me! I don't want to die like this!
Okay.
I don't know.
What?
Ow! Oh. Ooh. Oh, wait. Never mind. I am sick of waiting. I'm hungry. When we got to the city, it was already lunchtime. And then it was 1:30, and then it was 2 hours past. My other masters, as soon as we come to a new city, they find some place to stay and get something to eat. But this guy, no. He leaves his trunk at the station. He goes visiting here and there, wandering around like he's looking for some kind of like pokey things. And he forgets all about me, his poor, miserable servant who is starving. See, here's a perfectly good inn. I could go in, get something to eat, but that'll be just a minute that he comes looking for me. And besides, I have absolutely no money. Oh, poor Truffaldino. You do for your master. A soulless devil of a person. And what do you get for it? Starvation. I'm telling you, I can go no further. The weight of this trunk is killing me.
Only a couple steps more.
Oh, no, the trunk is falling. The trunk is falling.
I told you you couldn't handle this.
No, I got it. It's okay. It's okay. No, I got it.
Pardon, signore. May I be of service?
Thank goodness, Fred. Yes, can you help us bring this trunk into the inn there?
Immediately. Leave it to me. You pick it up like this.
Oh, thank you so much.
Your services are no longer required.
Oh. I am unused to this sort of work, and am disgraced by it. I am a well-educated man who is out of a job and now must slave for a living. What do you do with a B.A. in English? Oh, sir, excuse me,
but the fee for the portage is 10 pieces.
Are you mad? There's the street there. Go!
I'm not going. You have to pay me.
All right, here's 5 pieces for you.
But what about the other 5?
All right, here's 5 more.
Ow! Oh, my face! Ow! Ow! Sir, 20% gratuity is customary.
Of course, here's 2 more.
I am paid. Oh.
What a parasite that man is. Thought I was gonna have to beat him.
Everything is ready for you, senor.
Ah, is it comfortable here?
Oh, this is a very good inn. Soft beds, shiny floors, really hot house band, and the food. Oh, the smells alone could satisfy a person.
And what is your profession?
Oh, me. I'm a servant.
Ah, do you have a master?
At the moment?
Huh?
Truly?
Huh?
Nope.
Ah, how would you like to serve me?
To serve you? Well, why not? What do you give me?
What do you want?
Well, a former master of mine, who is no longer with us, I used to give me 5 lira a month plus expenses.
Good, then that is what I will give you.
Oh, and every now and again you give me something a little extra for special occasions.
How much of a little something extra for special occasions?
1 soldo a day for food?
Oh, very easily I can give you that.
Well, then it is settled. I am with you, sir.
Good. First, take this. Go to the post office and see if they have any letters for Florindo Aratusi. And if there are, bring them back to me immediately.
And in the meantime, you'll order dinner, sir?
Indeed, I will.
Oh! Yeah. Ooh, 1 soldo a day from him. That's like, that's like 30 days of September, April, June. That is a lot of soldi every month. It's pretty good. So we're off to the post office for our new senor.
So this is how you wait for me?
Oh, there you are, sir. I was waiting for you.
So how do you come to be waiting for me in the middle of the audience instead of in the street where I told you?
Well, they look very friendly, and yes, some of them seem to have some leftovers.
Leave it, leave it. Come on, come. Go and fetch my trunk, bring it to Brighella's Inn.
Oh, and look, my inn just happens to be right over there, so you don't have far to go.
On your way, stop at the post office and see if there are any letters there for me, Federico Rasponi, or for Beatrice, my sister, who didn't accompany me. I will be at the inn.
I don't know what to do. I might meet myself coming and going. You are the proprietor of this inn?
Yes, I am. Bring the trunk and you will eat well tonight.
Oh, boy. I was looking for a master. Any master now. Now I have 2 of them. It's not possible to serve so many. No. Well, why not? I could get paid for 2. Well, I could eat for 2. And if one of them sends me away, I'll always just stay with the other one. What could possibly go wrong? So, we are off to the post office for them both.
There's the servant of Federico Rasponi. You there?
Oh, sir.
Where is your master?
My master is at the inn.
Go and tell him I wish to speak with him. If he's a man of honor, he will come.
Oh, yes, but my good sir.
Go!
Yes, but I'm sure that my master will
want... Let's backtalk unless you want a quick trip to heaven.
Which master do you want?
Sir, immediately, or I will run you through.
I'm going. I'll bring back the first one I can find.
Federico may have escaped with his life once. He will not escape twice.
There, sir. That is the fire-breathing gentleman.
I don't know him. What does he want with me?
I have no idea, but if you'll excuse me, I'm going to go get the mail. Jigglypuff!
Sir! You have asked for me?
Me? Pardon? I don't even have the honor of your acquaintance.
I was told by my servant that you were inquiring after me in a menacing and imperious tone under the pretense of challenging me to a duel.
He misunderstood. I said I wanted to speak with his master.
Very well then. I am his master.
His master.
Certainly, he is in my service.
I beg your pardon. Your servant looks just like another whom I was looking for and who must serve someone else.
Oh, no worries. Mistakes happen all the time.
Are you a stranger here, sir?
I am from Turin.
The man whom I wish to challenge is also from Turin.
Ah, then perhaps I know him. If he has given you offense, I shall gladly help you obtain satisfaction.
Do you know Federigo Rasponi?
Ah! I know him all too well.
He is making plans with the young lady's father to make her his wife if she has already promised her hand to me.
Fear not, my friend. Federigo Rasponi will not trouble you any further. He is dead.
Yes, we all believed he was dead, but it turns out he lives, breathes, and is here in Venice.
I can assure you, Federigo Rasponi is very, very dead.
And I can assure you that Federigo Rasponi lives.
This is impossible.
Signor Pantalone, the father of my beloved has made every effort possible to verify that this man is who he says he is.
Then he was not killed in the duel, as I was led to believe. Where is this resurrected Rasponi?
He stayed at this inn.
At this inn? I've been told of no other strangers here.
If you see this Federigo Rasponi, tell him it's best if he abandon this idea of marriage, if he value his life. Silvio Lombardi is my name. It has been an honor to make your acquaintance.
It has been my honor to make your friendship, although I'm still completely confused.
And what is your name, sir?
He must not know the truth. My name, sir, is Luciano Pavarotti, at your service. Oh, dear Lord! I was told he perished on the spot. If he's still alive, I must return to Turin to console my dear Beatrice. What must she think? She must believe that I've abandoned her.
Hey, come on with me, bring the trunk. Oh, it's my other master, go back!
Yes, that must be what she believes. I must return to Turin at once.
Here I am, sir!
Ah. Troubledino, how would you like to come with me to Turin?
When?
Now, at once.
Before dinner?
No, we'll eat dinner first and then go.
Fine.
Did you go to the post office?
Yes, sir, I did, sir.
Give me my letters, please.
Yes, sir, I will. They're right. Oh, damn. I mixed up the letters of one master with the letters of the other. How am I supposed to tell them apart? I can't read.
Come on, give me my letters.
Sir, you see, here's the thing. Not all of these letters are for your honor. On the way to the post office, I met another servant who I know, and he asked me would I see if there were any letters for his master, and there was one, but now I can't tell which of these it is.
Why don't you give them to me? I'll keep mine and give the rest back to you.
Oh, there you go.
Dear Lord. A letter addressed to Beatrice Rasponi. Beatrice Rasponi is in Venice?
Did you find the one that belongs to my friend?
Who is your friend?
Oh, he's another servant. His name is Pasquale.
Who is his master?
I don't know, sir.
But surely if Pasquale asked you to pick up a letter for his master, he must have given you his master's name.
Well, of course he did. Oh, boy.
Well, what was the name?
I don't remember.
What?
Well, he wrote it down on a scrap of paper.
Where is the scrap of paper?
Oh, I left that at the post office.
Such confusion.
I'm just making it up as I go along.
Where does this Pasquale live?
I truly have no idea, sir.
Then how on earth were you going to get him his letters?
Well, I told him I'd meet him back at the square. If you give me the letter, I'll go see if I can find him.
No, I'm going to open it.
For shame, sir. You mustn't do that.
No. The letter is addressed to someone over whom I have a certain claim. I can read it without scruples.
Oh, no. My master is deranged. Proof positive.
Dearest,
God help me.
Signora, much has happened since you left Turin. All know that you have fled in search of your beloved Florindo. The High Council has learned of your escape dressed as a man and intends to hunt you down and bring you to justice. Your most loyal servant, Antonio.
That is just lovely, reading other people's mail.
What have I read? Beatrice Rasponi, in Venice, dressed as a man, in search of me. Oh, she is my love, truly. Go, dear Truffaldino, find this Pasquale, bring back his master, man, woman, whatever. If you do this quickly, you will be rewarded richly.
If you give me the letter, I'll go find him.
Here it is, and with it, I too am in your hands.
Yeah, well, what if they ask why it's been opened?
Just tell them it was an accident, a mistake.
Are we still going to Turin, sir?
No, go find Pasquale now. And if I find her brother, all the more misery for him. I must be reunited with my Beatrice.
Oh, boy. Somehow, I volunteered myself into the service of two masters. And now a letter for one master was opened by the other master despite all of my efforts to stop him. But I think I can fix this. If I fold it here and I fold it there, then all I need is a stamp to seal it. But oh, I know how to do that. I saw my grandmother once.
She used to seal letters with a little bit of chewed bread.
I need my bread.
Well, that's okay. That's okay, because I always keep a little bit. just to keep me from death's door. It's very, very simple. You pop a little bit in your mouth. And you chew it. That is so good. Oh. Oh. Damn. Okay. We'll try it again. You take a little bit of bread. I gotta save some for later. You pop it in your mouth. The secret? It's all in the wheat gluten. Gluten. It's like glue. I know, like nowadays, wheat gluten, public enemy number 3, right? People who don't look like us, Donald Trump. Sorry, Mom. Wheat gluten. But it's a good thing, the gluten. No! Oh. Third time's the charm. This better work, it's all I got left. You're not going anywhere, buddy. Got it. That's not going anywhere. It's a little bit for the squirrels. Oh, I forgot all about the porter. Yuna, come on with me. Bring the trunk.
Whoa. Where do you want this thing?
We want it in the inn. Come on now.
Whoa. Who's Papa Mayor?
Is this my trunk?
Yes, sir, it is, sir.
Bring it up to my room.
Which one is your room?
Ask at the desk. Ask at the desk.
Who's Papa Pan?
Just go and I'll pay you.
Immediately.
You'll get the money when the job is done.
Oh, I should have just left the damn trunk in the street.
Very polite, these porters.
Not anymore. Did you go to the post office?
Yes, sir, I did, sir.
Were any of my letters there?
Well, there was one that was for your sister.
Where is it?
Here it is.
Well, this letter's been opened.
No! Impossible!
Opened and then sealed with bread!
Well, how could that have happened?
Oh, you have no idea!
I have no idea!
Rascal!
Oh, whatever! Who would ever think to seal a letter
did
with
you
bread?
Open this letter?
No, I confess, sir! It was all a mistake! At the post office, there was also a letter for me, and because I don't read so good, instead of opening mine, I opened yours. I beg your forgiveness.
Did you read this letter?
No, sir. I couldn't make out the handwriting.
And it was seen by no one.
Sir.
Oh, very well. Come on. Go into the inn. Fetch my trunk. Don't fetch it. Just open it. Air out my clothing. When you return, because this is the key, we will eat. Ha ha! I have to go see Signor Pantalone. I must have that money. Oh, Florindo. Florindo.
Oh, I'm glad that's over. But it went pretty well, don't you think? I got a pretty key.
Tell me, fellow. Is your master at home?
No, sir.
Well, do you know where he went?
Not a clue.
But did he go to my house for his money?
You know, I think he did.
Oh, well, never mind. When you see him, give him these 100 ducats. I can't wait for him. I have things to do.
Massage.
Wait, Signore! I don't know which master to give this to.
Ah, good. Have you found Pasquale?
No, sir. But I did find somebody who gave me a purse with 100 ducats.
100 ducats? What for?
Well, were you expecting money from anybody?
Well, I did present a letter of credit to a merchant.
Oh, then it must be yours.
Ah, what did he say when he gave it to you?
He told me to give it to my master.
Oh, very well, then it must be mine. Am I not your master?
It could always belong to my other master.
And you really don't know who gave this to you?
I have seen him before, or him me before, but, you know, who, what, when, where, what, why, I got no idea.
But you'll remember Pasquale.
I will find him immediately after dinner, sir.
Ah, let's go order our meal.
Oh, that was a close one, but at least I gave the money to the right master.
Then it's settled. Federico Rasponi will be your husband.
Oh, you may be my master, father, sir, but you are acting like a tyrant.
When Signor Federico first asked for your hand, you didn't say no. Now's not the time to raise objections.
The subject, with all due respect, will result in my mutiny.
My decision is final.
I can't do it, father, sir.
No?
I will not marry Federico Rasponi.
You dislike him that much?
He is completely loathsome in my eyes.
There is only one cure for this.
What do you mean, sir?
Signor Silvio must be banished from this house and you'll never see him again.
No! Silvio is so much a part of me that if you send him away, it'll be as if you're sending me away too.
I've got to show some spine here. Be strong, Pantalone.
Master, Signor Federico is here and waits to see you.
He is here now and he is your master.
No, what torment?
Come on. Oh, that felt kind of nice, actually.
Hey, how could you not want a handsome man like this Federico? If I had your luck with men, I wouldn't be crying. I'd be dancing in the streets. Woo!
No more tears. We don't want him to see you crying.
No, but what else can I do when my heart is breaking?
Daughter.
A pleasure to see you again, Signor Pantalone.
The pleasure is mine, sir. Did you receive the purse with the 100 ducats?
I did not.
Well, I just left it with your servant. You insisted that he was an honest man.
Oh, not to worry. I just haven't seen him. That's all. He'll give it to me when I get home.
Oh,
is that Signora Clarice crying?
Dear Signor Federico, you must have some compassion. This news will take some getting used to. In time, she'll adjust.
Would you do me a favor, Signor Pantalone? Leave Clarice and myself alone together for a moment. Let me see if I can reassure her.
Sir, I will go. Daughter, wait here for me. I will return soon. You are to have a little chat with your betrothed. Go.
Signora Clarice?
Go away! And don't even try to persuade me!
You have been severed from the one you love.
You may have taken my hand by force, but you will never have my heart.
But I have something to say that I think will calm you down.
I will abhor you for all eternity!
If you knew what I know, then I know you would not feel that way.
You can't even begin to know how I feel!
But I do know how to console you.
Oh, no one can console me except Silvio.
Oh, if that were the only way to console you, I would give you your Silvio. But there's another way.
You are murdering me, Signor. My passion for my love is ardent, eternal, invincible.
Oh, Signora Clarice, I have a secret to tell you in confidence.
I don't want to keep your secrets. Besides, I wouldn't confide in me if I were you.
You are being deceived. You don't want me. I don't want you. We are both destined to marry another.
This is beginning to make me happy.
Shall I continue?
No, I'm afraid you'll disappoint me.
Oh, no, Signora, I'm not pretending, but you must promise me that this secret I'm about to tell you will go no further. You must swear, and I will put my life in your hands.
Oh, I swear you will have my strictest silence.
Oh, I am not Federigo Rosponi, but Beatrice, his sister.
Not one of them. Oh. You're a woman?
I most certainly am. Now do you think I want to be your husband? Well, I mean, if it were today, that'd be fine. Or at least there's increased awareness around gender identity, sexual orientation, LGBTQ issues, am I right? But it's the 16th century. I couldn't openly be a woman who loves another woman. I couldn't even wear pants. I mean, there's no pockets in those dresses. Pants, I'm just talking pants. All right, this has nothing to do with this story. I just personally felt I needed to make a comment. Okay, you understand. Now do you think I want to be your husband?
Oh, but what about your brother?
He was indeed killed in a duel, and the author of this mortal blow was my lover. It is searching for him that has brought me here in disguise. Oh, I plead by all that is sacred in friendship and in love that you do not betray me. Oh, I am afraid I have been incredibly rash in confiding in you. But you and your Silvio are in such pain, and I do not want that because I am in the same pain myself.
But you will permit me to tell Silvio, won't you?
Oh, no, that I must absolutely forbid.
Oh, I will say nothing.
Oh, respect my confidence in you. Give me your hand.
I don't know.
Why, are you afraid I'm not a woman? I'll give you evidence if I have to.
Oh. This seems unreal.
Oh, it's real. Believe me. Clarice, that's probably pretty...
Oh, sorry.
We should embrace as a sign of dear friendship and trust. Oh,
there is no longer any doubt in my mind.
Oh, this makes me infinitely happy. My daughter, you've taken him into your heart so quickly.
Oh, didn't I tell you, Signor Pantalone, that I could charm her?
Congratulations, sir. You have done in 4 minutes what I thought could not be done in 4 years.
Oh, now I'm in real trouble.
And now that this is settled, we'll be having the wedding immediately.
Not so fast, Father, sir.
Oh, come. I saw that hugging and kissing. You're getting married tomorrow.
It will be necessary, Signor Pantalone, that first we settle the dowry, take care of all our accounts.
We will do all that, but these are things that can be taken care of in a matter of hours. Yes.
Father.
Oh, yes, my daughter, I will go and tell Silvio. Yes.
Oh, for the love of God, don't make him angry.
Well, why not? Do you want two husbands?
I didn't say that, but...
Oh, but nothing. This is settled. Good day, sir.
Well, listen, we could...
Signora Beatrice, this is worse than it was before.
Have patience. This all has to work out, or I'll have to marry you.
Father, please, leave this to me.
Quiet! And listen to me for once!
I am beside myself!
What compelled you to come to Signor Pantalone's house?
Because I want... By not keeping his word, he has rendered me a terrible insult!
Oh, but there is not a damned thing that you can do here! Now, am I going to have to drag you away by the collar?
He has mistreated our family! He doesn't merit a bit of respect!
That's true! But we have to be cautious in this matter! Now, leave this all to me, Silvio. Maybe I can enlighten him as to just where his duty lies in this matter. Okay, so go home. I will wait for Signor Pantalone alone.
But I, Father, sir... Oh,
but I, son, you will have to obey me.
I obey you, sir. I will go. But if Signor Pantalone persists in this, he will have to deal with me. Father, you never let me do anything. I'm 16!
Poor boy. Millennials, am I right? But Pantalone should never have led him on unless he was quite certain that the man from Turin was dead! I want to remain calm and rational when I see him. I can't let my temper get the better of me.
What is the doctor doing in my house?
Oh, Signor Pantalone, at your service.
Imagine that, sir. I was just coming to find you and your son.
Wonderful. I had imagined you would come in search for us, if only to assure us that Signora Clarice would indeed marry Silvio.
Oh, actually, I was coming to say
No need for any explanations. I have sympathy for your predicament. We have always been the best of friends, and we will let bygones be bygones.
Naturally, with all the promises...
Oh, he took you by surprise. You had no time to reflect, and of course you did not think of the insult to my family.
Well, there can be no insult of an
contract. I know what you're going to say. When you had first spoken, you thought you'd made a contract with Federico Rasponi, which seemed unbreakable. But ours is a contract between Clarice and Silvio, and ours is confirmed by a young girl's love.
Yes, that is true. But what
and
I was going to
you
say
know as
is,
well as I do that the marriage contract states consensus et non concipitus facit oerum.
Well, I am no Latin scholar,
a
sir.
A young girl's happiness cannot be sacrificed.
Have you anything else to say?
This is all I have to say.
Are you finished?
I am finished.
May I speak?
You may.
My dear doctor, with all of your knowledge
a little more, a little less. I'm not too worried.
Let us begin again, shall we? Will you permit me to speak, sir?
Speak.
As I was saying, the law is all well and good, but in this case it does not apply.
And you are telling me this other marriage is to take place?
My word is my bond, just like Melania. And what's more, my daughter is happy. I was just coming to tell you and Signor Silvio this now. I am sorry, sir, but there is nothing more to say. Sorry.
I am not astonished at your little daughter, but I am astonished at you, at your horrible mistreatment of our family. The news of the death of Federigo cancelled all his claims on your daughter. And furthermore, the marriage contract between my son and your daughter, coram testibus, cannot be made or broken just by a word from you. You must give concrete reason to render void this new contract, or else your daughter will be obligated to take my son as her husband, and you will lose all honor you have in our house. She will be the daughter of a man without honor, and that is how I will see you and her. Remember what you are about to do to me, Signor Pantalone. Remember what you are about to do to the house of Lombardi. There will come a time to pay. There will come a time. Omnia tempus habent!
No! With my blessings, one Rasponi is with 100 Lombardis.
My father speaks well.
Oh, and here comes the little one.
At your service, sir.
Yours to command, sir. Oh, his panties are in a wad.
I have just heard what you have to say to my father. Is it true?
It is true.
The engagement between Federigo and Clarice is confirmed.
Confirmed and resolved.
You are a man without honor, without reputation.
Is this how you speak of a man of my age? Is this how you speak to your betters?
I don't care how old you are. I have a mind to run you straight through the body.
I am not a shish kebab, sir. You threaten me in my own house.
Step outside. And we can handle this as gentlemen.
I am used to being treated with respect.
You are vile, cowardly, and common.
Why, you little vile piece of impetuous impudence.
I swear to heaven.
Father-in-law, I am here to defend you.
Son-in-law, just in time.
Here's the man I want to fight.
Oh, this wasn't part of the plan.
Oh, come, sir, steel to steel.
Careful, he's on fire.
This isn't the first time I fought for a woman.
Hello.
Not bad. Oh, come on, quick, sir.
Hey!
Oh, I got a little zing. I see a little zoom.
Little boy, oh, you have done it now, so watch this.
Toro, Toro.
Yes, sir. Toro, Toro. And you are the bull, sir. Yes.
Yeah!
It's part of the plan.
Why would you
it's part
fight
of my
with
plan.
Your cape?
It's the part about
that. Ruin a perfectly good costume piece.
No. Oh. Well, all's well that ends well, you'll find with me. Over here, sir.
Oh, there you are.
While I'm young.
Oh, this does really catch you. That's nice. Mm-hmm.
I find it matches my eyes, the red.
Wait a minute.
Not my face! Sir, I will follow you to the end of the earth! Faithless deceiver.
What? No, no, Silvio. I love you. I adore you. I am forever faithful to you.
Oh, dear God, that's too much. Is it faithful to promise to marry another lover?
What? No, I have done nothing. I will do nothing. I would die before I abandon you.
I just heard you promise yourself to him.
But that promise does not bind me to marry him.
Then what does it promise?
Dear Silvio, I can't say.
Why not?
Oh, because I promised to be silent.
Promised whom?
Federigo.
And you tell me that you do not love him. I don't believe anything you say anymore. You deceiver, get out of my sight.
No, Silvio. I love you with all of my heart.
I despise you with all my soul.
I'll die, and then you'll be sorry.
I would rather see you dead than unfaithful.
Oh, well, then you shall have that satisfaction.
Yes, that's the only way you could right the wrong done to me.
Are you so cruel to your own Clarice?
You're the one that taught me cruelty.
Then you want me to die?
I don't know what I want, really.
I do.
She's overreacting about it all.
You little dog.
What?
You were going to let her die?
No.
Do you have the heart of a beast?
No.
Oh, yeah. Woo. Yeah, check me out. I'm about to go Game of Thrones on your ass. And you.
Whoa. Oh, you were much too kind to him, madam. He doesn't love you anymore, I suppose. Well, if he doesn't love you, then he doesn't deserve you. There's no shortage of men.
I can find you a dozen more by evening. Hey.
Ingrate! Is it possible that I should die and you would feel nothing? Yes, I'll die, and then you'll be happy.
Stand up.
But there will come a time when you will learn that I am innocent. Too late, and you will cry at my slander and at your barbarous cruelty.
No.
There is one thing I really don't understand. A woman with whom you are in love with runs in here, saves you, and then tries to kill herself, and you sit there looking on as if you were watching a play.
Oh, you're crazy. Do you honestly think she was going to kill herself?
I guess we'll never know.
But if I hadn't arrived in time, that poor girl might be dead.
I am done with women for it. Hey.
Yes, and hopefully they are done with you.
I don't think so.
As they say. That such large trees can grow from such small nuts. When women are unfaithful, we say sluts and whores. But when men cheat, we say boys will be boys. Thank you. Oh, okay. Something else with women? Everybody gossips, right? I mean, my Facebook feed is filled with women being called things that I have to look up on UrbanDictionary.com. Do you know what that is, sir? Well, it is very enlightening. But with men, nobody says a word, right? We're not critical of men. They're just little babies. We can't take care of them. Well, not for long. November 2016. And one day, I'm going to be in charge, and I'm going to make a law that every unfaithful man, every stupid man, and every man who has turned this down, I mean, really! They're all gonna have to carry a tree branch in their hands. And then we'll see all of our cities looking like forests. I'm going to take this, but I will leave it on the props table.
Okay. Stop laughing at that. Back to me. Yes. My ungrateful Corice is unfaithful. She's a liar. And this pretense at suicide was a trick to make me feel sorry for her. Ha! I will never give up on my thought of revenge. Not even a clap. Wow. That wretch shall die. And my ungrateful Corice will see her lover wallowing in his own gore.
Yeah.
my luck. Two masters, neither one of them comes home to dinner. I was all ready to do two at once. Serve two, get paid for two. Oh, here comes one.
Well, have you found Pasquale?
Well, sir, didn't we say that I would look for him after dinner?
Oh, I can't wait.
Sir, look, I have already ordered dinner. The food is going cold. Everything is going bad.
I'm not hungry. I must return to the post office and find Beatrice.
Sir, in this country, we have to eat. If we do not eat, we get sick.
I have some errands to run. Have some food if you like.
Oh, yes, sir. You are the master, sir.
Here is some money from the letter of credit. Go put it in the trunk. Here is the key.
Oh, I bring the key right back, sir.
No! If I don't return in time for dinner, come find me at the piazza. We must find Pasquale.
My disposition and my hypoglycemia are not suited to not eating. I'm just gonna put this in his trunk, then I'm gonna sneak in the kitchen and...
Hey!
Oh, damn.
Travolino!
Yes, sir, sir!
Did Signor Pantalone give you a purse with 100 ducats in it?
Yes, sir.
Then why didn't you give it to me?
Why, I was just coming to give it to you.
Oh, you were just coming to give it to me. What did he say when he gave you the purse?
Well, he told me to give it to my master.
So?
So it must be yours.
Where is the purse?
Oh, here it is.
Is it full?
I haven't touched it.
I'll count it anyway. Where is the innkeeper?
He's right here, sir.
Tell him I'll be having a friend joining me for lunch. We'll need a little more food at the table.
Oh, yes, sir. Now, how would you like that served? How many courses?
Well, tell them to prepare 5 or 6 platters. That should be plenty. And take this paper and put it in my trunk. Handle it with care. It's a letter of credit for $250,000 scudi.
Don't worry. I will take care of this right away, sir.
Please do, and be sure that everything is ready.
This is the first time that my master has asked me to order dinner for him. I'm going to show him that I am a man of good taste. Oh, but first I should probably put this piece of paper away, right? Hey, Brighella!
Yes?
Brighella!
Yes! Troubledino, what can I do for you?
My master is having a friend over for dinner, and he needs a table prepared quickly, immediately. Now, do you need any help in the kitchen?
Oh, no, I'm always ready for anything in 1/2 hour it is possible for me to have anything that he wants on the table.
Well, I am glad to hear it, but tell me what you will cook.
For 2 people, I would do 2 courses of 4 platters each.
Well, he wanted 5 or 6 courses, but 7 or 8 would be better. So what's on the menu?
For the first course, we will have a soup, risotto, boiled meat, and a friggin' dog.
Well, now 3 of those things I have heard of, but the 4th I do not recognize.
Oh, it is a French dish with a sauce. Very tasty.
Sounds very satisfactory. So much for the first course. Tell me about the second.
On the second, we will feature a roast, a salad, grilled meat, and a trifle.
A trifle?
A trifle.
My master and his guest are gentlemen of substance. They will never be satisfied with a mere trifle.
Oh, you don't understand. A trifle is an English dish, a pudding. And I'm the only one in Venice that makes it.
Well, sounds good. But tell me, how will you lay all of this out on the table? I want to be able to picture it in my mind so I can see that everything is in order.
Well, I would put, for example, the soup here, the risotto right here, the meat just so, and the friggin' dough right there.
Well, and in the middle you put nothing? What?
Well, in that case, you would need to order 5 platters.
Yes, please. 5 platters.
All right, well then there in the center I would put the sauce for the meat.
No, the sauce does not go in the middle. The soup. The soup goes in the middle!
What? No! Everything has to go in a certain order! Where else would the sauce or the meat go but there?
Man, you clearly have no idea what you are doing! Please, allow me to instruct you. Watch carefully how I lay out the 5 courses. See, in the middle, you put the soup. The soup always goes in the middle. And then over here, we would put the meat. Yes? And over there, you put the risotto. And where does the sauce go? Where do we put the sauce? The sauce goes there. And over here, you put that other thing that I never heard of. Now, you see how that will work harmoniously? Isn't that much better?
Very good, but the sauce is too far from the meat.
Well,
what are you doing?
I am trying to teach Brighella how you set a table.
What is that paper?
Oh, damn, the letter.
The letter of credit.
Sir, I can put this all back together again.
I got it. Do you know what that was to me? Do you know how important that was?
You got it.
Well, that was not helpful at all.
Sorry, pardon me.
Oh, you deserve a terrible beating.
I will do it myself, sir.
Signor Pantalone, have you ever seen such a dimwit?
Oh, it would be much more serious if it couldn't be fixed. I can always write you another one. No harm done.
Yeah, this never would have happened if Brighella knew how you set a table.
Get out of here!
I am a man who knows his business.
Go away, I said!
You will never find a better butler in the world than me!
Sometimes I think he's smart. And sometimes I think he's completely stupid.
He's insane! Oh, sorry, Mick. That's the guitarist. Did he at least tell you about lunch?
Yes, Signor. He said he wanted 5 platters post-haste. I'll go alert the kitchen and take care of this.
Please go and tell Truffaldino to come and serve, and thank you.
I will, sir.
My dear sir, I am overwhelmed at all the attention that you show me. In fact, you are doing for me what I ought to be doing for you. You know, if it weren't for you, I would have been killed.
I'm only glad I arrived in time.
Oh, they have the fastest service at this inn, and they're all such good dancers.
Lunch is served! This way, please!
Go and put the soup on the table.
Oh, after you, sir!
Your servant is, most unusual.
I would like a little less unusual and a little more service.
Can you call that a lunch? One course at a time. They got money to burn. They got nothing to show for it. I mean, I wonder if the soup is even worth eating. Only one way to find out, right? Fortunately, I always come prepared. It's not bad. It could be a lot worse.
Where's the fella to come take this dish?
Here I am. What do you got for me?
Boiled meat.
Boiled meat?
I'll go get another plant.
Okie doke. What do you think? Mutton or veal? Only one way to find out, right? Oh, it's lamb. Meh. Very good, too.
Where are you going?
Uh-oh.
Where are you going with that plate of food?
I was going to put it on the table, sir.
For whom?
For you.
What are you doing serving dinner to me before I've arrived home?
Well, I saw you coming through the window.
And why is that the main course and not the soup?
Well, here in Venice, sir, the soup is always served last.
Well, I'm not used to that. I want the soup first. Take that dish back to the kitchen.
Yes, sir, as you wish, sir.
Hurry up. I want to eat and then take a nap.
Yes, sir, sir.
Oh, Beatrice, will I ever find you?
Coming!
Where's that servant again?
Now, here I am. Give that to me. Quickly now. Go set a table in the other room. The other gentleman has just arrived. Bring him his soup right away. What do you think that is? Must be the frickin' dough, I'm thinking. Because I don't know what it is, so, you know, better give that one a taste. Whoa! Frickin' dough. That must be French for frickin' tasty. Same time, and that's gonna be an accomplishment. Hurry up now, get the soup.
Oh, you take care of your own people, we'll take care of the rest.
I want to take care of them both if I can. Come on now. Give me that. I'll take that.
What?
Let me go get the stuff from the other room.
Oh, let him serve, everyone. We'll split the tips anyway.
Trouble dinner!
Now my master is calling for me! 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004, 1000. 5 second rule.
He wants to do it, I'll let him. Oh, he probably thinks he's gonna get all the tips.
I take this in there myself, but I don't want to deal with that maniac.
Hoppa!
Here, super waiter. Take these risoles to your master.
Risoles?
Yes, the ones he ordered.
What am I supposed to do with these? Which of my master's gonna order risoles? Now, if I ask in the kitchen, they'll begin to suspect me, and if I bring him to the wrong master, then the master who ordered him will ask after him. I'll get found out. I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to split the risoles onto two plates. And then I bring half to one master. I bring half to the other master. And then the right master is sure to get them. So we take a one risole, two risole, three risole, four, five risole, six risole, seven. I got one left over. Who should get this one? I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings, you know. Looks good. These people never feed me. Oh my God. All right. So, four risoles to this master. Seven. Wait a minute!
That's wrong! The risoles go over there!
I know they go over there! I already brought them over there!
Uh-huh.
Now my master sends these four to this gentleman over here as a courtesy!
Oh, I see! So they know each other! Well, they might as well just dine together!
What do you got for me?
This is an English trifle.
Who is it for?
Oh, it's for your master!
No way! What is this trifle anyway? Smells like polenta. But it can't be polenta. It's gotta be better than polenta, right? Guess we better give this one a try. Let's see. Oh, that is not polenta. That is so much better than polenta.
Trouble dinner!
Yeah, they're coming!
Trouble dinner!
Wait a minute! Just one more mouthful. Oh. Mm-hmm. Oh my. Polenta from.
Oh, when you're done.
Thank you. Oh, hey!
Please come and serve the next course!
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Be right there, sir. Wait for me, baby. I'll be back.
Devil Dino! Where the devil has he gone?
Right here, sir! Here I am!
Where were you? Were you lost?
No, sir. I had to go get these two plates.
Was there anything else coming, you know, ever?
I will hurry them up in the kitchen, sir.
Oh, please do hurry. I want to eat and then take a nap.
Waiter, is there anything else?
Well, here's the roast. Where are you?
And don't forget the fruit.
In a minute. Relax.
Wait. Here I am.
What are you doing? You don't toss the fruit. What are you?
Diego! My head is safe! Why is it that you always want to talk to me?
He is a maniac!
He dances this way and that. It's like he's doing the tarantella.
That's it! Nobody wants anything else!
Oh, I'm so relieved.
Oh. This was worse than Hell's Kitchen.
Now you can lay a table for me.
This guy.
What? Hey, I did it! I served them both and everybody's happy! Yeah. Only problem is, you know, I can serve two masters at two tables at the same time, and neither of them knew one thing about the other. The problem is when I serve for two, I feel like I gotta eat for four. Hello, sunshine. Come to daddy. This trifle and me, we're gonna need about 10 minutes. So, you know, you can go get some popcorn, get some ice cream, some Guatemalan handicrafts. Amuse yourselves. We'll see you after the intermission.
Round to get everyone started.
All right, so let's start with the frisco-letas.
La trompeta. There you go.
Right.
With the Italian hands. I like it.
And last but not least, la trombona.
Hey guys. 5, 6, 7, 8. Bamba, bamba, la trombona.
Yay! Okay, so feel free to clap along. Just like that. And sing, please.
Hey, good morning. Hey, boys and Hey, come on, 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 hey, come on,
La trompeta,
zinga, zinga, violina,
du, 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 saxofona,
clinka, clinka, mandolina,
tweet, tweet, frittoletta,
everybody, everybody, everybody.
Papa la trompeta,
zinga zinga violina,
tutto tutto saxofona,
clinka clinka mandolina,
frittoletta,
everybody, everybody, everybody,
hey! Grazie, grazie.
Gombare, come se sono la smeraldina.
Bippity boppity boom.
Come on.
As I was saying, I'm just an innocent young girl. I can't be alone in a tavern by myself. To serve a woman in love is a tough business, that's for sure. I have done a million things for my mistress that I don't question, but there is one thing I don't understand. If she's so in love with Signor Silvio that she will spill her blood all over him, then why is she writing secret letters to another man, huh?
Woo!
Yeah!
Oh,
yeah!
Oh, yeah! What? Yeah!
No! 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 It's too much for my virgin eyes and ears. I'm gonna go sit down over here and wait. Someone will come out. Hello, out here, anybody?
Somebody call for me.
It's me, senor. I'm sorry if I'm bothering you.
Not at all. I am yours to command.
I've taken you away from your dinner.
Oh, yeah, it's true. I was eating, but I can always go back to it.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, I am delighted. I to tell you the truth, I've eaten my belly full, and your beautiful eyes are just the thing to help me digest it.
He's very gallant.
I'm going to put this bottle over here, and then I will be right with you, my dear.
He calls me my dear. My mistress sends this letter.
Oh, yeah, it's good.
To Signor Federigo Respone, but I don't want to go into the inn, and I was thinking if it wasn't too much trouble, as you are his servant, that you could give it to him.
I will take it with pleasure, but first, you must know that I have a message for you.
From who?
Oh, from a very honest man. Tell me, have you ever heard of a certain Truffledine Batocchio?
I seem to recall meeting someone by that name, but I'm not sure. That must be him.
Well, he is a very handsome man. Uh-huh. He's short, witty, knows his business well.
Oh, I must not know him.
Well, yes, you do. And he really, really loves you.
He's a charmer. Woo!
If it were possible to hope for a little correspondence, perhaps you could get to know him better.
Well, sir, if I were to see him and if he were to my liking, then of course we could correspond.
Would you like me to show him to you?
I would like to see him, yeah.
Well, then I will bring him out immediately.
What just happened here?
Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! No! Are you okay? Oh!
Did you see him?
Who?
The man who was madly in love with your beauty.
I didn't see anybody but you.
Well,
wait a minute. Are you saying that the one who thinks I'm beautiful and is in love with me is you?
Yes, it is.
Well, why didn't you say so in the first place?
Well, because I'm incredibly shy.
The man would make a stone fall in love with him.
So what do you say?
I say...
Oh, come on, tell me.
Well, I'm incredibly shy, too.
Oh, we're perfect together. We could be a marriage of the incredibly shy.
I belong to no one in the world and have been given to no one.
If someone wants to marry you, what would he have to do?
I have neither father nor mother. He would have to speak with my master or my mistress.
And if I spoke with them, what would they say?
They would say whatever makes me happy.
And what would you say?
I would say whatever makes them happy.
Say no more. We'll all be happy together. If you give me the letter, when I bring back the answer, we can have a chat. Oh, my glass.
A lot of stuff going on here.
Oh, the wind. The wind.
The wind. The letter.
Windbreak.
My bosom. Everything.
What? You got the letter?
I got it. Here.
Do you know what it says?
No, but I'm bursting with curiosity.
Why? Because I don't want to get in trouble. If it's bad news, I don't want to take it.
If it could be opened, then we could see what's inside.
Oh, yeah.
Again.
Oh! Leave that to me! I can seal a letter as well as the post!
Perhaps we should open it then!
Do you know how to read?
A little. But I'm sure you read well.
A little.
We will figure it out together!
Okay then. All right. So, we must open this letter. We must open it very, very carefully.
What have you done?
Oh, that? That's nothing. I can seal this up well as the post. Come on, I got a secret way of doing it all. Come here.
Okay.
It's open.
Go. Read it.
Boy, you read it. I'm sure you know. We must know your mistress's handwriting better than I do. Oh. Oh. Oh!
Oh! No, I can't read that.
Well, yeah, me neither.
Well, what was the good in opening
it? No, wait. I can make out some of it.
Oh, I know some of the letters too.
But we'll work it out together. See now, like right here. Isn't that an M?
Well, oh, come on! That's an R!
An R? Well, between an M and an R, there's so little difference anyway.
Oh! Oh, no, you're right. That is an M.
Oh!
Yeah.
M.
Mm. Yeah.
M. My?
Mm-hmm.
No, it's a mo. M-O.
Oh.
Mo.
No, there's that little, curvy
it's
thing.
Curvy? No.
That's a Y. Ma, lie.
What are you doing?
Nothing, sir. Looking for you.
What do you want with me?
The mistress was looking for you.
What is that letter?
Oh, it is nothing, sir. It is just a little scraplet of paper.
Let me see it.
Yes, sir.
What? This letter is addressed to me. Why do all my letters in this play arrive opened?
I know nothing, senor.
Tell me about it. Who opened it?
Well, not me.
Or me?
Well, who brought it?
Oh, Truffaldino was going to bring it to his master.
Well, Schmeraldino brought it to Truffaldino.
Oh, you. I don't like you anymore.
You are a disgrace. I have a good mind to give you a beating.
Oh, you would strike a woman? I am sure.
Oh my, that is quite a little bucket cake.
You bet I will, little
Missy! I guess we know what I got coming.
Poor Clarice. She is desperate over Silvio's jealousy. I should reveal myself and put an end to their suffering.
I don't think he's looking. Maybe I can sneak away.
Where are you going?
Nowhere.
Why did you open this letter?
Well, I didn't open it. Schmeraldina did that.
You opened it, you rascal. This is the second letter of mine you've opened today. Come here. Come on. Come.
Oh, have mercy, I don't have a senor. Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! Hey! How come you're beating my servant?
Oh, you're killing me! No more, I beg of you! Oh, my Lord! Oh! Oh!
Stupid ears. Oh! That ought to teach you to open other people's letters. Like the kid said, be smart. It's a federal offense.
That ought to teach you to open other people's letters. Oh, I think I'll hit your hat. Whippee-yay!
He beat the snot out of me. I mean, that's my body. What have I ever done that people should treat me that way, huh? Beating on me. If you're not happy with your servant, I mean, you can just send him away. You don't have to beat on him.
What did you say?
Oh, I was just telling all of my friends here that certain people have no business beating on other people's servants. That is an insult to my master.
Yes, it is an insult to me.
What?
Who was beating you?
I do not know, sir.
Then why were you being beaten?
Why? Because I got spit on his shoes.
And you let yourself be beaten for that?
What?
You just stood there and didn't defend yourself at all. And in doing nothing, exposed me to mockery, insult, injury, and all the consequences there it implied. There and implied. Yep. There you go. Keep it up. Still in a good rhythm. Yeah, there you go. Don't stop. Don't stop. Not yet. Not yet.
Well, I guess there's no doubt about me being the servant of two masters. Today they both paid me my wages.
Go! Work. All I do is work. And they never help me. I got this. Who wants a treat? Who wants a treat? Who is a good servant? You're a good servant. Who's a good boy and a good girl?
Who's a good boy and a good girl? I just give it a treat.
Take this. Open. Here you are. Good servants. Ha! Huh.
Well, it must have been some sort of congressional mandate saying it was National Beat Your Servant to the Point of Rapture Day or something. But I've eaten well. and full. I'll eat even better tonight. And if everything works out, I'm gonna get 2 salaries. Because I'm 1 servant, I got 2 masters. Y'all keeping up? My first master is God knows where. The other one's upstairs, he's asleep. And they've asked me to air out their trunks. Unfortunately, both of them have left me their keys so that I... They asked me to air out their trunks. And unfortunately, both of them left me their keys so that I... Joseph, cover me. Their trunks. Unfortunately, they both left me their keys. Thank you. About time, right? So I can do both of them at once. Now I just gotta figure out which of these trunks goes to which of these keys in Vasky Versky. So I don't know. This way, that way. My friend in front here. What do you think? Yellow trunk or green trunk?
Food.
No, it's a trunk.
Food.
Food? What color food? Green food!
No.
We said green food, broccoli, spinach, all that good stuff. Like your hair. All right, so we're going to try this. We're going to try this in the green trunk. And oh! The family down front gets it right. Very good. And for that, for getting that answer right, you get a little Guatemalan llama. You can share if you want. Don't be jealous, folks. You can all get your own after the show. Okay, good. So that means that this key over here must go to the yellow trunk, which it does. Whoa, Nelly. And now I can do both of them at once. Save us all a little bit of time. See what all's in here. Got to air out. Ooh, musty, musty, musty. Nasty. Ooh. Bumblebee pantaloons. Who would wear these in this day and age? I don't know. Hang on that for me, will you? Just air it around a little bit. Let it get some wind. Oh, a little coat thing. Stay there, sweetheart. Must have unbalanced it with this book. Books are heavy. All right. What about if that one will stay put? What about this one? Got a little, little coat there. Got a little stuff here. Got another book. I mean, like these people never heard of Kindles. Stuff is so heavy. Stay. Now, when you're airing out people's things, it is very important that you check the pockets because you never know what might be left inside. And they pay you so poorly. So, you know, any bit of spare change, or even like pocket lint, or sweets, anything. Oh, what's that? A portrait. Oh, that is beautiful. Who could that be? He looks very familiar. And he doesn't dress like that.
Oh,
he's awake. I better put all this stuff away. If he catches me with the second trunk, I'll catch hell for it. All right, so
are you coming, or do I have to come down there and beat you again?
In a minute, sir! Oh, no, I forget where some of this stuff goes. I mean, this coat, that coat, the book.
Vino!
I'm coming, sir. We'll just throw it all in. I'll let God sort it out.
The devil are you doing?
Well, didn't you ask me, sir, to air out your things?
Whose trunk is that?
Yeah, I don't know, sir. It just kind of appeared here. Must be some gentleman who just arrived.
Give me my black coat.
Yes, sir. Your black coat,
yes,
sir.
Yes, my black coat.
Okay, I'm coming, sir, with your black coat.
Right sleeve?
Yeah, I'm getting it.
Right sleeve.
Left sleeve.
Left sleeve.
And coat in the middle. Very good, sir.
What is this?
Oh, no. I think I put the coat of one master into the trunk of the other. Why do they all wear the same black coats?
Good heavens.
It's my portrait, the one I had made for Beatrice. But how did it get in my pocket? I didn't put it there. I gave it to Beatrice.
Well, there must be an answer, sir. I don't know what it is, but I will in a second.
Talk to me. Say something. This portrait, how did it come to be in my pocket?
Oh, dear master of mine, that portrait came to be in your trunk because it belongs to me. And I put it there to keep from losing it.
Where did you get it?
It was left to me by my master.
Left to you?
Yes. I had a master, and he died. And he left me some things, most of which I sold on eBay Arini. But I hung on to this portrait. It is all of him that I have left.
Good heavens. How long ago did he die?
Not long. Maybe about a week ago. I'm just making this stuff up.
What was his name?
I do not know, sir. He lived incognito.
Incognito? How long did you serve him for?
Oh, not very long. Maybe 10 or 12 days.
Oh, dear God. I'm trembling all over. He must mean Beatrice. She fled just as a man lived incognito. Oh, the anguish if this is true.
I think he's believing it. I must be telling this really well.
Tell me, was he young, your master?
Oh, yes, sir. He was young.
Without a beard?
Oh, without a beard.
Where was he from?
I don't remember, sir. I used to know.
Was he from Turin?
Yes, sir, that was it. Turin.
Oh, reward is a dagger in my heart. Oh, how did he die?
Oh, he met with some sort of accident or other, and that was the end of him. I think that's gonna do it.
Where is he buried?
He wasn't buried, sir. Another servant from the same town got permission to have him put in a coffin and sent home.
The servant, was it perhaps the same one that you encountered at the post office this
morning? Yes, sir, that was Pasquale.
All hope is lost. Beatrice is dead. Unhappy Beatrice. Oh, I can no longer endure the agony of my grief.
Portrait really touched him in the guts. I guess he knew the guy. Oh, I better put this stuff away. Oh, my other master. Oh,
believe
you taking me those?
Your pantalone, this last part needs to be looked at again.
Well, it is certainly quite possible my clerk made a mistake. We'll have a look at the books one last time.
I have a duplicate copy of the ledger in my trunk. We'll compare them and see who's in error. Oh, Truffaldino.
Yes, sir.
Do you have the key to my trunk?
Oh, yes, sir, I do, sir.
Why have you brought my trunk out here?
Well, didn't you ask me to air out your things?
Have you done that?
I have done.
Whose is this other trunk?
Oh, I don't know. That belongs to some other gentleman who just arrived.
Give me my ledger of accounts, which you'll find in the trunk.
Yes, sir. Oh, heaven help me this time.
As I said, it is quite possible that a mistake was made. And if that's the case, you'll not have to pay.
It's quite possible everything's fine. We'll see.
Is this it?
It should be. Well, no, this isn't mine.
What have I done now?
Oh, these are two letters. I wrote to Florindo. Oh, these accounts. Oh, they are his.
Signor Federigo, are you not well?
Oh, no, it's nothing. Oh, Troubledino, how would a book that doesn't belong to me get into my trunk?
I don't know. Maybe.
I won't beat you. Just tell me the truth.
I beg your pardon for the liberty that I took in putting the book into your trunk. It belongs to me. And I put it there to keep from losing it.
If it belongs to you, why didn't you recognize it? And why did you give it to me?
Oh, this master's a lot smarter than the other one. I have not had the book very long, and so I did not recognize it at first.
How did you get this book?
Well, I had a master here in Venice, and he died and left the book to me.
Oh, how long ago?
Not long, maybe 10 or 12 days.
Oh, I'm finished. Oh, this master, was his name? Florindo?
Yes, sir, Florindo.
Of the Aratusi family.
Exactly, Aratusi.
And he's dead, are you sure?
Oh, he is absolutely, positively.
Oh, how did he die? Where is he buried?
Well, in Venice, sir. He fell into a canal. Oh. Disappeared. Was never seen again.
Oh, my despair. Florindo is dead. From this moment on, my life has no meaning. If Florindo is dead, what is the point of my remaining alive? Unhappiness will strangle any joy I might have.
I left my home, abandoned my family, dressed as a man. I risked my life for Florindo, and Florindo is dead. Oh, Beatrice, the adventurer! So soon after the loss of my brother, I must suffer the loss of my only love. Oh, grief overwhelms me. I can no longer bear the light of day. Oh, my adored one. Oh, my beloved. I will follow you into the tomb.
Truffaldino.
Signor Pantalone.
A woman.
Well, I am reluctant to engage in such a binary discussion of gender, but it appears so, yes.
I've got to go tell my daughter.
And I guess I gotta tell these people they've been watching the wrong play. I'm sorry, folks. It seems that I'm not the servant of two masters. I'm the servant of one master. And one mistress. Oh, boy.
That old buzzard Pantalooney tunes get the best of us. Oh, the more I think of him, the more my bile churns.
Oh, Doctor, good to see you again. Oh,
I am amazed you have the gall to greet me.
I have good news. You know...
Oh, you were about to tell me they've already been married. Well, I care not to think if they
have. No, that is not at all what has happened. Now, let me speak or you'll regret it.
Speak, please, and then I'll give you a piece of my mind.
Oh, I just want to hit him. It's about my daughter and your son.
Oh, go ahead. I don't have to listen. You may give her to the touring gentleman.
But if you knew who this touring gentleman was, you'd speak differently.
I knew. All I need to know. He has been seen with your daughter at Hook Sufficient.
Wait, but the real truth.
Oh, I don't want to hear it. La 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 la.
If you won't listen, it'll be all the worse for you.
Oh, we will see for whom it'll be the worse.
My daughter was a girl of unblemished reputation.
Go to hell!
You go to hell! How could I tell him that the man is really a woman if he wouldn't let me speak, the big buffoon? Oh, and here comes his mini-me.
There you are.
Signor Silvio, I would like to give you a piece of good news if you would condescend to allow me to speak, unlike your windbagged father.
What do you have to say to me?
Speak! Well, you must know that the marriage between my daughter and Signor Federigo has been called off.
Is it true? Do not deceive me.
I am telling the truth, and if you still have feelings for her, Clarice is willing to give you her hand.
Oh, dear heaven, you bring me back from death to life.
Yeah, oh, my colon.
But what about the other marriage?
Well, to cut a long story short, Federigo has transitioned into a woman.
What? I don't understand.
Yes, I'm not sure that I do either. But the person that we believe to be Federigo Rasponi has actually been revealed to be his sister Beatrice.
Dressed as a man?
Dressed as a man.
Well, now I understand.
Oh, it's about time.
How did it happen? Tell me.
Come to my house. I'll tell you all about it there. Clarice doesn't know yet. Come, come.
Sir, I beg most humbly your pardon of my recent behavior. I was overcome with passion.
Oh, I can forgive the things that love makes us do, you little... Come on.
Who can be happier than I am? What heart can be more content than my own?
You care for me?
No, this is madness!
Oh,
do I see?
Florindo!
Beatrice!
Oh, is it you?
Is it you?
Oh, my love!
Oh, my soul!
Oh, sweet mystery of life, at last I found thee. I know at last the secret, are it her? Oh, the waiting, striving, seeking, longing, yearning.
Oh. If every knife fight ended like this, wouldn't be such a bad thing.
Sorry, awkward. What drove you to such a desperate act?
I was told you were dead.
Who told you that?
My servant.
Mine told me the same thing about you.
It was seeing your ledger book that made me believe his story.
Where did you get that? That was in my trunk and in the pocket of my coat. I found this portrait that I had made for you in Turin.
Huh? Oh, these servants are up to some sort of shenanigans, and where are they?
I don't know, but we'll find them, and they'll have some explaining to do. Hello, is anyone in there?
Dingle!
Oh, my Croft, hold. Oh, where are our servants?
I don't know, so I can go look for them.
Find them and bring them to us immediately.
Well, I only know the one, sir, but the waiters are sure to know them both. Your servant, sir, and... ma'am.
Tell me, your brother, Federico, is he dead?
Oh, you doubt it. You delivered the fatal blow.
I was told he was alive and well and living at this inn.
Oh, it was I who traveled under his name and in his clothing in search,
in my search love. Of me, yes, I know. Oh. I read it in your servant's letter.
Oh, how did that get into your hands?
Well, my servant gave it to me by mistake, and seeing that it was addressed to you, I could not resist opening it.
A lover's curiosity.
You saw nothing!
This is the only one we could find! We will go and find the other one.
All right, now how about you tell us how the ledger book and portrait came to be switched? And by the way, what's up with your missing cohort?
Wait a minute. May I speak with you in private, sir? Just be patient. I will come back. I will tell you everything. Sir, the thing you must understand is that none of this is my fault. It is all because of Pasquale, the servant of that woman over there. It was he who mixed up your things without me knowing anything about it. And the poor man, he begged me to take the blame for him because he was afraid that she would beat him. And because I have a good heart, I made up any excuse I could on the spot. I never dreamed that it was a portrait of you or that you would be so upset on hearing of the death of the owner.
What's taking so long?
So the servant from the post office this morning is the servant to Signora Beatrice?
Yes, sir. That was Pasquale.
Well, if you knew how important this information was, why did you keep it from me?
Well, he begged me to stay silent.
Who?
Pasquale.
Why did you betray me?
Sir, I did it for the love of Pasquale.
Are you finished?
For the love of God, sir. Do not tell on Pasquale. You can tell her it was all my fault. You can beat me, but do not give up Pasquale.
You are so devoted a friend to Pasquale.
I love him as if he were my own self. Sir, I will not give up Pasquale. I'm going to go tell that woman that it was all my fault. Let her do what she will.
Well, he certainly is a loyal and affectionate fellow.
What is this long story you've been telling, Signor Florindo?
Madam, that gentleman over there, he's got a servant named Pasquale, who is the biggest fool in the world.
Oh.
He was the one who mixed up all your clothes and things. And the poor man, because he was afraid his master would send him away, he begged me to take the blame. So I had to make up the whole thing, the book, the dead master, all 9 yards. I've been over there just telling Signor Florindo that all of it was my fault.
Well, why would you accuse yourself of faults you've never committed?
Madam! I do it for the love of my friend Pasquale. Oh.
Signora Beatrice, obviously the other servant cannot be found, but since no irreparable harm has been done...
I think we can pardon all that has transpired. I'm going to my room to change. Then we'll go to Signor Pantalone's.
No matter what you're wearing, you're still the most beautiful woman in the world.
Oh. Florindo, I have not endured for the love of
you. Oh, the boot feels good. It's nice. Yes. Well, this day has certainly been filled with the grandest emotions and accidents.
Oh. Sir, I would like to have a word with you, if I may.
Yes, what is it you'd like to say?
Well, sir, I would like to ask you for a favor.
Well, you hardly deserve it, but what is it?
Well, you see, sir, I too am in love.
In love?
Yes, sir, and my love is the servant of Signor Pantalone, and I was hoping that you would put in a good word for me.
How does she feel about this?
Oh, she wants me too, no doubt about it. Just a good word from you, I can take care of the rest.
Well, I promise that I will do that, but how can you possibly support a wife?
Oh, I'll do whatever I can. Maybe I'll ask Pasquale to help.
Oh, no, I think you'd better ask someone with a little more sense.
Ow. If I don't show sense this time, I will never show it again.
Together. You can see that Signor Silvio has repented. If he acted foolishly, it was all for the love of you.
Show me a measure of pity, Signora Clarice. Let me assure you that my love for you is true. And when I spoke to you this morning, it was only my fear of losing you that made me so furious.
Signora Clarice, my dear daughter-in-law, take pity on the poor boy. He was nearly driven out of his mind.
Oh, my God. Will you please shut up? Signora Mistress, what can you do? Men, some a little more, some a little less, have all been nothing but cruel to us. They demand absolute fidelity, and on the smallest shadow of suspicion, they bully us, mistreat us, practically murder us. You've got to marry one or another of them someday, so I say to you what one says to sick people. If you have got to take your medicine, just take it.
Signora, I know I deserve your punishment, but I plead for your pity. Punish me with your words, not your silence. I am at your feet. Have mercy on me.
Cruel. Oh, do you hear that sigh? That's a good sign.
Strike while the iron is hot. If I could think that you desired my blood to avenge my supposed cruelty, I would give it to you with all my heart. But, oh God, instead of the blood in my veins, accept that, I beg you, that which gushes from my eyes.
Bravo!
Oh, he's got her!
Get up! Stand up! Stand up for your rights! And come on, come together!
Father.
Join hands! Celebrate! And be happy, for the heavens have blessed you.
There, it's done.
Stop.
Done and done again.
Have pity on me, Signora.
My great.
Dearest.
My human.
Beloved.
Monster.
Angel.
Going?
Forgive me, for the love of heaven.
Going?
I forgive you.
Gone!
Go on, Silvio. She has forgiven you.
Oh, yeah.
The illness has been cured. She has given him the medicine.
With your permission, sir, may I come in?
Oh, do come in, my good friend Brighella. You who assured me that a certain party was Federico Rasponi, eh?
There were like twins in those clothes.
Well, never mind all that. It's all done. What's the news?
Signora Beatrice is here and would like to talk to you.
Oh, she's most welcome. Bring her in.
Oh, poor Signora Beatrice. I am happy to think that her troubles are over.
You're sorry for her.
Oh, yes, of course.
And for me? That's
a good cruel.
Friends, I come to beg your forgiveness, for it is all on account of me that you have been so disturbed.
Oh, come here.
Oh, no, friend.
Excuse me.
What? Can she not embrace another woman?
I must say, Signora Beatrice, you show remarkable courage.
Love can do anything.
And you found your young gentleman at last,
oh,
so I hear.
The heavens have made us happy.
Now that I am happy, I want the whole world to be happy. Who else is getting married?
Oh, how about me, sir?
To whom?
To the first man that walks in the room.
My greetings, ladies and gentlemen.
Where is Signor Florindo?
Oh, he is here, and he would like to come in by your leave.
Oh, Signor Pantalone, will you welcome Signor Florindo?
Is that your young gentleman?
We are going to be married.
Oh, bring him in.
I have missed you, my dear.
What are you?
We should have a little talk.
About what?
Well, would you be interested in a little...
Why not?
Oh, we'll talk.
Can I ask a favor of you?
Oh, what is it?
I'm just a poor girl trying to find her place in this world, and the servant of Signor Beatrice wants to marry me. So if you could put in a good word to his mistress, I would be the happiest girl in the world.
Oh, yes, of course. As soon as I can speak freely with Signor Beatrice, I will.
Oh, noble servant, ladies and gentlemen. Are you the master of the house?
I am, sir.
Allow me the honor of introducing myself. By the grace of Signora Beatrice, who commands my life.
Congratulations, sir. I congratulate you on all of your good fortunes.
Signora Beatrice has agreed to marry me, and I was hoping that you would agree to give away the bride.
Oh, let us do it immediately. Come together. Yes.
Are you ready, Signora Beatrice?
Oh, Signor Florindo, I am yours.
Oh, that was quick. That's quite sporting. Stop that. All right. Fair. And that's our accounts are settled.
Huzzah. Oh, my friend, I am so happy for you.
And I for you as well.
Everything is in order. Everything is settled. Strike up the band.
The best is yet to come, ladies and gentlemen.
What is that?
Remember your promise, sir.
What did I promise you?
You promised to ask Signor Pantalone to give me Schmeraldina for a wife.
Yes, of course. I'll do that right away. Signor Pantalone, I know we've just met, and the honor is mine, but I was hoping I could impose on you for a favor.
Well, ask what you will. I'll do what I can.
My servant has requested to marry your maidservant. Do you consent to this arrangement?
Oh, great! Another one wants me. I'd like to meet him first, at least.
Well, I have no objections. What do you say, young lady?
Well, if I thought that he, whoever he is, would make a good husband, I'm
sure. Is your servant a good, honest man?
In the time I have known him, he has proven himself to be faithful and smart.
Signor Florindo, it seems you have preempted something I should have done. I was to propose the marriage of my maid to the servant of Signora Beatrice, but since you've already asked on behalf of your servant, proceed with your arrangement.
No, I withdraw my request. You were first.
Oh, well, I don't want my request to receive any preference over yours, and since I had not spoken yet, I must defer to you.
Signor Pantalone, I appreciate your consideration, but please disregard that I said anything at all. I absolutely do not want my servant to marry that woman.
Oh, well, if your man shall not marry her, no more shall the other man. To preserve honor, we must be fair on both sides.
Oh, great, they're going to honor me right out of a wife.
I will have neither one nor the other.
But the poor woman wants to get married, if not to one, then to the other.
Well, it won't be to my man. I will not do such a dishonor to Signora Clarice.
Oh, and I will never permit this affront to Signor Florindo.
Sir, madam, maybe I can help settle this. Signor Florindo, you asked for the hand of Schmeraldina for your servant, did you not?
Yes, weren't you listening?
Yes, Signora Clarice, now you were to ask for the hand of Schmeraldina for the servant of Signora Beatrice, were you not?
Yes.
Good, so if that is so, then Schmeraldina, give me your hand.
Wait, what claim do you have on her hand?
Well, the claim of the servant of Signor Florindo and Signora Beatrice.
What did you say?
Signor Florindo, on whose behalf did you ask for the hand of Schmeraldina?
Yours?
Good boy.
Oh, my hat.
Signora Clarice, whom did you have in mind as the intended husband of Schmeraldina?
Yourself?
Ergo, Schmeraldina is mine.
Signora Beatrice, where is your servant?
Why, here, Truffaldino, of course.
Well, Truffaldino is my servant.
I thought yours was Pasquale.
Pasquale? I was sure Pasquale was yours.
What's been going on here?
Rascal!
You charlatan!
You
when serving two masters at the same time?
Yes, I was! And I did it pretty well, you gotta say. I took the job without thinking, just to see what I could do, and it only lasted for a day, that is true. But at least I can say that nobody would have found me out if I hadn't given myself away for the love of this girl. I've done a hard day's work, and I made a few mistakes, but you gotta admit it was a hell of a show. If only for that reason, my hope will be that you will show with your hands that you pardon me.